Well, speaking of how we got here, Shane, let's break down some of these games. And let's just start right there with the theme where the Florida Gators lost to Missouri on the road 24-23 in overtime. And this was, a little bit of a hard game to watch at first. It was a defensive battle, a field goal battle, back and forth. I thought both these coaches were kind of playing it conservative down the stretch until we got into overtime. Then things got a little bit of wacky here, and Tyler Beatty put the team on his back once again. Dan Mullen asked Emory Jones to carry the team. The running game was not exactly working, playing a little conservative. But in the end, Eli and company went for two. They went for the win. And we're seeing that more and more in overtime. It seems like teams don't want to mess around and get into a two-point shootout here. And they used Tyler Beatty as a decoy, and Connor Bazelak hit, I believe it was Daniel Parker, for the two-point conversion to win the game. And I just want to play this real quick, Shane, because we all remember the Darth Vader. Well, old Eli, to end his presser, hit him right back here, and this is kind of going to be the lasting legacy of Dan Mullen here at Florida.
May the force be with you.
All right, Shane, may the force be with you, as it is old Dan Mullen. I mean, I could not believe your brother Jonathan, he asked if Eli was going to do something like this. I said, no way, no chance in hell. Yet here it is. He pulls it out. He pulls out his damn lightsaber. And, man, isn't college football, the SEC in particular, there's nothing better than this. You know what?
I'm telling you, man, Eli is a smart ass. And this is just something he's been thinking about this all year long. You know what I'm saying? He didn't make any comments about it after Dan did it last year. But, man, this is one he kept in his back pocket. And it wasn't just that, Mike. I mean, he took to Twitter. He's liking. He's retweeting. He's sending pictures with him and the wife out on the town enjoying the game. I mean, he is enjoying it. And they should, rightfully so, Mike, because Florida is not an easy team to beat, clearly. Hell, Tennessee Vols didn't even do it on the down season. So, celebrate it, man, because you just don't know how often these wins are going to come by. And it was a hell of a game, Mike. It was, like you said, it was really, really ugly there at the beginning. In fact, it was tough to watch, even with that commentary, man. I was like, oh, my God, can we play some Christmas music in the background or something, you know? It's there for a while. It was a little tough. Who was the commentator? Was it RG3? Is this the one that he did? No.
He did Auburn, South Carolina.
Yeah, we'll get to that one here in a minute. But I'll say this, Mike. When it got crunch time, man, that third, fourth quarter, man, you could tell this thing was going to be a nail biter. And I was glued to it. I couldn't stop watching. I kept wanting to flip over there to the Arkansas game, but I was glued to this Florida-Mizzou game because I just had no clue who's going to win it. I lost money, lost my ass halfway through this thing because I thought Florida was going to run away with it there for a brief second. And then as soon as I submit the bet, all of a sudden Mizzou's like, not so fast, my friend. It looks like Shane's got a little money on this thing. Let's start playing. And I just basically, he took the team. He put the team on his back yet again, and he carried them to victory. And the two-point conversion, gutsy. Mm-hmm. Very risky. That was a hell of a play. I think it was a little broken up. It didn't look like it was designed that way, but credit to Mizzou for going for it, man. I'd love the fact, hey, how many opportunities you got to beat Florida Gators? You know, you let them stick around. You let Emory run around. Anything can happen. You had an opportunity to win. That's what Eli did. He went out there, and congratulations to Mizzou Tigers.
Yeah, and we'll play these comments.
Hell, congratulations to Florida. There's a lot of people that – I ain't going to lie, Mike. I seen it on Twitter. Don't act like you ain't. But there's a lot of Gator fans like, well, at least we can get a new coach out of this thing, you know?
Yeah, and – I wish I knew who wrote this. I'd give him credit, but I did see it on Twitter where someone said, do you think Eli bought that lightsaber after Samford put up 42 in the first half on them Gators? I mean, that was the perfect comment, but we'll get to Drinkwitz post-game comments after this. But apparently on that two-point conversion, Shane, that was Tyler Beatty that called the play. He said they've been watching for the screen and shadowing him and yelling every time he goes out there. So he, even though he's the best player on the field, best player on Missouri's roster, you know, he didn't demand the ball. He called him for a decoy and it worked beautifully. So, that's a credit to Tyler Beatty right there, where, you know, he just makes such an impact on the game even when he's not touching the ball. And this Missouri season was going sideways here, Shane, midseason. I mean, they look like one of the biggest disappointments in the SEC. We got to give them credit. They got a lot of young guys that are stepping up. They got a lot of veterans that came back. I thought this was tremendous. Eli, after the game, said, you know, our center, Michael Miotti, he was he's the transfer from Rutgers. He's played 2 years now at Mizzou.
Wait, what's his name?
Michael, I think it's Miotti, something like that. But he came.
Like Mr. Miotti?
No.
Come on, Mike. Somebody's running with this one, right?
Not at all. Okay. The same. But he came back because he's never played in a bowl game. And now they've punched their ticket to the postseason, Shane, by beating the Florida Gators, beating, you know, a team I'm sure they consider a rival after the brawl, after the Darth Vader. And, you know, again, credit Missouri, man. The arrow is pointed up. And, like, it would have been very easy for them to, you know, give in. And they weren't picked, I don't think, to beat South Carolina. They weren't picked to beat Florida Gators. Yet they've done it here. And now they're not going to be picked against Arkansas either. But, hell, I'm giving them a shot after seeing them play here on Saturday.
Man, I just, Mike, I'm going back to Tyler Beatty. And if they don't put a damn a statue in front of that stadium, you know, there's a reason that Mizzou's going bowling. And it's not because of anyone on that staff. It's not because anyone on that roster other than Tyler Beatty. I guarantee you remove him from this equation, you've probably lost another three games during the season. That's just the impact that he's had on this thing. And I know we're going to talk about Matt, and we're going to talk about Alabama and some of these other Heisman candidates. But, golly, when I think of a Heisman candidate, I think of the guy that is the team. Mm-hmm. That without him, the team suffers. And I think, man, you got a strong case here that without Beatty, that they wouldn't be where they're at right now. I mean, 13, he's killing it, man. Receiving, rushing, every game, it seems like every week we're talking about Tyler Beatty putting it up and getting a victory for him. So I think, I don't know, they better wear a sticker on the helmet or something during a bowl game or something, because this kid needs to get out there more. And it sucks that more of the national media attention is not talking about it. Mm-hmm. But I cannot wait to put this kid on my fantasy football team next year.
Really fortunate that Tyler Beatty really came on. Forrest Strong in the third and fourth quarter. He actually called the pass to Nico. He told me they were yelling screen and said, call the, we call it burn, call burn. I was like, no, that's a crazy idea. And I was like, no, that's probably a pretty good idea. So we called it and hits for a touchdown. So then he, you know, puts us on his back right there at the last two plays. So really proud of Tyler. You know, seniors are, it's interesting now, right? Because seniors transfer in, some of them have been COVID seniors, they've gone through a lot, you know. For the last 18 months, I don't think anything's gone the way they expected it to go, with COVID, an extra year, a new coach, new position coaches at multiple places, and yet they continued to show up every day and give us everything they had. And you know, all week we just talked about, man, this is senior week. These guys deserve that chance to grab that rock. And that was special. And, you know, I promised Mike Maietti he'd go bowling if he came back. That's the only reason he came back, because he'd never been to a bowl game. We came through today for that. So that was good. You know, people chose to come here. And some people didn't choose me, you know. And coming together is a process. It doesn't happen overnight. And we're just coming together. You know, whether it's the seniors who came back, whether it's through COVID, through adversity, through people leaving, through people coming, it's a process, and we're building on that process.